zeroing in the BSA Sweet 17 scope, which is made specifically for the 17 HMR. After you get your scope mounted, you'll want to make sure that it's leveled and installed correctly. You can buy these little levels at most any gun store. They're fairly inexpensive. If you notice, I got one here and also one up here. Not only to make sure that the gun's level this way, but also that it's level that way. And once you got that done, then you can get ready to start getting your group together to zero this gun in. But let's go through the scope real quick. Right underneath the flip-up cover here, there's a quick focus ring. Here you have your magnification ring. There's a cutout window there to tell you, you know, what your magnification is at. This is your parallax knob. Here you have your elevation, and over here you have your windage. Up front, this is a 3-inch sunshade, which comes with a scope, and that's a nice feature. Now, one click of the elevation and the windage knob equals a quarter of an inch at 100 yards, and or 1/8 of an inch at 50 yards. But you'll want to take and zero this scope in at 100 yards. Okay? And I normally use a 5-shot group and then make my adjustments from there. So once you got this thing zeroed in and you're right on, well, first of all, before we go any further, you'll want to make sure that this parallax knob is set at 100 yards, because that's where you're going to be zeroing from. Okay? Well, once you have got your group together, you've got your scope zeroed, right underneath this level here, there's a set screw. You take and loosen that set screw up, and you pull out this drum, and you'll notice that there's different yardages marked on there. In fact, two sets of them, one for the 17 grain bullet and one for the 20 grain bullet. Okay, you take and pull that out, and you'll take and set the dial to 100 yards at your zero point. And your zero point is going to be, there's a couple of little notches right here, so you'll set that right on there. And reason for that, once you get ready to, say, shoot at 150 yards, at 200 yards, or 300 yards, what you would do, you would come here and turn this knob out to 150 or 200 yard, and then also turn the parallax knob to match whatever you're shooting at here. And hopefully that makes a little bit of sense on how to zero this scope and that is if you're having problems with the instructions that come with the scope.